Hello, my friend. Welcome back to my channel and thank you for supporting. Okay, just go straight to the discussion. The first step is to set up on the Midjourney server. Change the light upscale setting to regular upscale. Then click the plus sign and select upload file after selecting the photo file, then press enter. Right-click on the image and copy image address. Then type the slash imagine prompt. Then paste copy image address. Type the words handsome Pixar, smile expression, make headphone, and press enter. You can combine whatever prompts you want, such as cartoon style, line art, anime style, pop art, robotic, or cyberpunk. But I'm here to change it to a Pixar model. And I made this video to answer questions in the comments column, how do I turn a photo into an animation? If there is input for the progress of this channel, please comment in the comments column. Okay, back to the tutorial. I tried experimenting by changing some prompts like angry expression and blue hair, and add the keywords you want to create. I'm just giving an example like the one in the video, and you can try to create it yourself later on your computer. Actually, there are other ways to make generative art. If you run out of ideas or keywords, just use ChatGPT. You can ask anything, and ChatGPT will help you find lots of creative ideas, including prompt code, and we will discuss this in the next topic. Wow, Midjourney is still the best among generative art for now, even though a lot of free generative art has sprung up. Okay, let's try another style. As usual, type the slash in the imagine prompt, then copy image address. Why do you have to copy the image address? Because if you don't use a copy of the image address, chances are that the resulting image will be of a different style from the photo that was first entered. Therefore, it is very important to use copy image address if we want to create consistent character styles. Looks good, right? The generated results using the copy image address tip style will not be much different from the original photo. This time we are trying to enter a vector-shaped file, whether it can or is it appropriate if it is changed to the Pixar style. Upload file and select file, then press enter. I'm trying to upload a vector with writing on it. Don't forget to right-click on the uploaded image, then click copy image address. After that, paste and add the prompt or words we want to make. I try to enter 3D render, then press enter. Let's see the result. Wow, the result is not what I wanted. I thought it would be a 3D cow, but apparently not. Very far from the design that we uploaded. Okay, I'll try again by uploading the vector file but with no writing in it. Upload the file and repeat the same steps as before. Don't forget to copy image address, because each design that is uploaded is a different copy of the image. So it is very important if we want to make a character or design according to the photo we entered. Very good results this time. From the file that we uploaded, not too far from the original file. Maybe I can conclude something in this tutorial. If we upload a file that has writing or letters in it, the generated results will not match even if we use the copy image address method, but if we upload a file that doesn't have letters or writing in it, then it will be appropriate, and that's my personal opinion. These are some ways how you can turn a photo into a cartoon or anime. But keep in mind, this method may not be the same if the prompts used are too many combinations, such as entering the word photorealistic, wide angle, CGI, hyper detail, high quality portrait, and other prompts that are specifically for photography, not for Pixar, cartoon, anime, or 3D. To produce an extraordinary digital artwork, we are required to learn how to become a professional artist. By continuing to learn from various sources, don't be lazy to analyze relevant keywords. If you are an anime fan and want to create digital works with anime style, then look for styles and prompts that will support your digital artwork. Success requires hard work, right? Keep studying and learning even though you are smart. Just for information, if you want to make art using keywords like nude, naughty, bitch, porn, or keywords that contain pornography, your artwork will be banned and cannot be generated, so don't use keywords like that. If this video is useful, please click like, comment, and subscribe to continue to support this channel so that it continues to provide information about technology. See you in the next video, and have a nice day.